being a man is just following your true self and finding out who you are and going after those things. And you know, when you fail, take responsibilities and own up for those failures and find out a new way, something that works, and do things differently, do things better, and just take responsibility. I enjoy fear. I love the idea of fear. I mean there's so many things that we can fear as men. I mean, you could fear going over a big waterfall. You can fear stepping in a cage with another man that wants to kick your head off. But the way you deal with it is that you go in there and you embrace it and you face those fears and you just you accept that fear is part of it. And you go through those fears, and you enjoy it. You enjoy that process of facing your fears. The only way you're a failure is if you give up, if you stop trying, you give up. You know, and there's so many ways to give up. You can give up by not showing up mentally and not showing up emotionally or physically. I mean, you can just not be there. But you can show up and not be there mentally and just not be focused. Don't give up chasing anything. I mean, find something that you want to follow and something you want to chase and enjoy that process. If you're successful, people want to be around you. And so you have an obligation, you have a responsibility to lead the way for other people and show them that anything's possible, that they can chase their dreams too and they can follow their passions. So being successful is honestly, it's about doing what you love to do and following your passions, but it's also inspiring others to do the same. The only way to fail is to quit trying. I've had major setbacks, I've had major roadblocks, I've had, you know, every kind of obstacle in my way that could possibly come up. I've overcome those, I've fallen short, I've started over. But there's no way to fail unless you quit trying. You just got to keep going. You got to face your fears, and you got to overcome all obstacles. And you've got to just got to take action. That's what it's about: is getting out there and moving forward, physically and metaphorically and mentally, and just going forward. Everybody wants to put everybody in a little category. This guy's a wrestler, or this guy's a fighter, and no matter what I do, people want to find a label for me. But I'm pretty hard to label because I'm myself, I'm who I am. I'm the guy that's going to chase my dreams and follow my passions. And along the way, I'm going to hopefully inspire others to do the same. And ultimately, I'm going to coach them to, you know, if they come to me and ask me how they can get to where I've been or go somewhere else, I'm going to share my insight, my knowledge, and hopefully some of my wisdom that I've developed along the way. I've coached a lot of champions. I've coached NCAA champions. I've coached world medalists, guys that have been on Olympic teams, and UFC champions. And that, I mean, that's, you know, it's great for me, but coaching's not about me. It's about them. It's about giving back, and it's about sharing, and just loving the people that you're involved in their lives. And so I don't know if I've accomplished much, honestly. I think it's about helping other people accomplish their goals. You know, I've won some awards though, and I'm grateful for those opportunities that I've had to win those awards, and I'm grateful to be recognized as a champion in the areas that I've participated and competed in. But I don't think I've really accomplished what I'm going to accomplish, which is changing this community and, for the better. I mean, you know, in 20 years, I'm going to see this community look completely different because of what I've given back and the fact that I've been here, that I've participated and changed some lives. And that's what I want to accomplish.